This is Dr. Cynthia First, and today I'd like to talk about superposition. Superposition is a powerful circuit analysis tool that often lets us simplify our circuits to find power from multiple sources by analyzing each source individually. For example, you could analyze the engine separate from the wind turbine, separate from the solar panel, and then add them all up to find the total power in the system. Here are the steps for applying superposition in circuit equations. The first thing is to identify your independent voltage and current sources. You keep the first source and zero out the others. The dependent sources you leave the same. In order to zero out a source, you convert a voltage source to a short circuit, a current source to an open circuit, and of course, you don't change your dependent sources. In step 2, you solve for whatever voltage or current you are interested in using any method in your ECE toolbox. Finally, in step 3, you repeat those steps for each of the independent sources until you have the voltages and current from each source. Then you add them all up to find the total voltage or current that would have been in your circuit. Let me show you what I mean. Here's example 3.9 for your textbook. Let's say that we have two sources, IS1 and VS2, and then we want to find this current in the branch. So the first thing we do is we set up our circuit so that we can analyze IS1, which means we have to make all the other sources go away, convert the voltage source to a short circuit. In the second circuit, we'd want to analyze just VS2, and we need to make this source go away. So we turn it to an open circuit. In this case, we want to find the current in this branch, and here we want to find the current in that branch. This gives us two circuits that look something like this. We can see that this is a very nice current divider. G1 is 1 over R1, G2 is 1 over R2, and the I that we would be looking for, the I from the first case, is going to be our I from the source, which is I0, or 6 amps, times G2 divided by G1 plus G2. That's what we put here. In the second case, we can see that we have basically an Ohm's law circuit where we have a total resistance, which is the sum of these two resistors in series. And then the current, notice which direction the current's going, so it's minus, would be V0 divided by R1 plus R2, and that would be our second current. That's what would go here. You'd simply add them up, and that would give you the total current in the system. Take a look at example 3.9 for the numbers in this problem. Now I'm going to go through a couple other examples so that you can just see the method. You'd have to work through the numbers, but I just wanted to quickly go through several ways of setting up superposition problems. Here's problem 227. We did this in the Kirchhoff's law examples. And in this case, we had two sources, VS1 and VS2. The first circuit we're going to set up is going to use VS1 and short circuit VS2. The second circuit is going to use VS2 and short circuit VS1. Let's suppose that we wanted to find this node voltage right here. If you take a close look at these circuits, you will see that none of the resistors are in series and parallel. So one way to do this would be to convert them from delta to Y circuits, make them into series and parallel, and then add them up. Another way would be to use Kirchhoff's law, or perhaps node voltages. Any way you solve this, you'll come up with a V21 and a V22, and the voltage that you're interested in, V2, would be the sum of these two. Does that apply to the currents as well? Yes, in fact it does. Let's suppose that we wanted to find I3. I3 would be I3 from our first case, that's right here, plus I3 from our second case, that's here. So the point is that you can take combinations of voltage sources, convert them into simpler circuits, two simpler circuits in this case, be able to solve for a node voltage or a current, and be able to sum them up to find the total voltages and currents in the system. Here's another problem. Remember this one from our Kirchhoff's law examples? In this case, we had three voltage sources over a set of resistors. It was a fairly complicated little problem to solve. We could solve this a different way by considering first V1 and short-circuiting these other two. We could then solve for V2, short-circuiting these, and we could solve for V3, short-circuiting those. Let's suppose, for example, that we wanted to find I1. The nice thing about these simpler circuits is we can see that we have combinations of series and parallel circuits. These are in parallel, for example, in series with R1, which would let us use a very simple Ohm's law equation to find I1. In this case, we have three in parallel and one in series, which would allow us to use a combination of Ohm's law and current dividers, and in this case, similarly. In all cases, let's suppose that we wanted to find I1. That would be I1 from our first case, plus I1 from our second case, plus I1 from our third case. Here's another example. In this case, we have two independent voltage sources, a VS1 and an IS2, and we have a dependent source. The first thing that we would do is solve for VS1 and open up IS2. The second thing we would solve for is IS2 and short circuit VS1. Let's suppose that we wanted to find this voltage. We would then solve for VL1 and VL2, and we'd add them up in order to find the total voltage. Here's a final example. In this case, we have a VS1 and we have a dependent source. Since we have only one independent source, there's no sense in applying superposition in this case. Just apply a combination of voltage and current dividers in order to be able to find the voltages and currents in this circuit. So in summary, here are the steps for solving superposition problems. Begin by looking at the independent voltage and current sources. Keep the first one and zero out the others. Zero them by converting voltage sources to shorts, current sources to opens, and dependent sources. Just leave those the same. In step two, solve for any voltage or current that you want using any of the methods in our ECE toolbox. Then, repeat these steps for each of the independent sources separately. Add up the voltages and currents that you divided from each of those, that you calculated from each of those steps, to find the total voltage or current in your system. This gives us a new tool in our ECE toolbox. This particular tool is interesting because all of the other tools can feed into it. You simply take all of your sources and analyze them individually using any of these methods, any combination of these methods, to be able to solve for the individual currents, and then you simply sum them up in order to find the total at the end.